Hi everyone, welcome back. It is almost May, and it looks like we're in for more of this, huh? I'm gonna start with a tune that's been requested by a number of you guys, and that for no other reason, I just haven't gotten around to playing yet. So dive into it here. It's the first time I play this in years, I think, too. So. She may be young, but she only likes old things. And modern music, it ain't to her taste. She loves the natural light, captured in black and white. She sees mirages of mountain ranges. Within the blink of an eye, it changes back to the open plain. She tries but can't explain. I cry, oh love, keep your arms around me. I am a bird that's in need of grounding. I'm built to fly away, never learn how to stay. The night is gonna fall and the vultures will surround you. And when you're looking in the mirror, what you see is gonna sound you. But all these lines and grays refined, they are the maps of our design of what began on a Monday morning. Monday morning, Monday morning, oh. Night is gonna fall and the vultures will surround you. And when you're looking in the mirror, what you see is gonna astound you. And while the glow of youth inside the wounds, it's burning on inside of you. It all began on Monday morning. Somebody was asking me, the person who asked for that song, I believe Adam Roderick asked for it on the Instagram. I believe it was him, maybe it was somebody else asked me why I don't play a lot of songs from Codes and Keys, or why we don't play a lot of songs from Codes and Keys. And I don't have a great answer for that. I think that record is a kind of an outlier in our catalog. And it represents kind of a very strange time in my life. I was living in Los Angeles and felt really detached from reality, the real world, and most importantly, my bandmates and my community back in Seattle. And so I think there's some really good songs on that record. There's some stuff I like, but it just was a very, very odd time in my life. And I think maybe I unfairly associate the record with that. That's a reason for that. This song was recommended. Song was requested. Maybe also recommend it. by a gentleman named Agrowski. His handles, I don't know, man.
Smear black ink. Your palms are sweaty, and I'm barely listening. The last emails. I'm staring at the asphalt, wondering what's buried underneath. Where I vinyl sticker with big block letters could hear into my chest that tells your new friends I am a visitor here, I am not permanent. The only thing keeping me dry is you seem so out of context in this gaudy apartment complex. A stranger with your door key explaining that I'm just visiting and I am finally seeing why I was the one worth leaving. Why I was the one worth leaving. DC sleeps alone tonight. You seem so out of context in this gaudy apartment complex. A stranger with your door key explaining that I'm just visiting and I am finally seeing why I was the one worth leaving. Why I was the one worth leaving. The district sleeps alone tonight after the bars turn out their lights and send the auto swerving into the loneliest evening. And I am finally seeing why I was the one worth leaving. Why I was the one worth leaving. Why I was the one worth leaving.
That was the first song that we did for the Postal Service record. And it made sense that it would just be the first song on the record. But that was the first piece of music that Jimmy sent to me back in late 2001, maybe early 2002. I think immediately we kind of knew, like, oh, this could be kind of good. Maybe people might like this. And it was a very odd world to live in after that record came out, because we had done a couple shows touring it, maybe like 4 weeks of tour, and then the record just kind of blew up after we were done doing it. So there was all this pressure to kind of go out and promote the record that we had already kind of finished promoting. And then we did that tour in 2013, which was kind of a reunion tour of sorts, and had a blast, and then put the band to bed. But I'll always look back fondly on that that record and that time with Jimmy, because he's a great dude. And Jenny Lewis, for that matter, who played with us on the tour. All right, I'm going to play a newer song for you guys here. This is from the record Thank You for Today. And I think it's, I think it might be my favorite song on this record.
Heaven is a hole in the sky. The stars are cracks in the ceiling at night. And I just keep watching them for a sign that you'll be alright. So every time there's a knock on my door, I fall to my hands and knees on the floor. It's when your wreckage washes up on my shore, you're not like before. And you try to explain who's at fault for your mistakes. I won't be the debris in your hurricane. Used to be such a delicate kid, a lonely fish in a sea full of squid. So I can't blame you for leaving how you did. You just fell off the grid. 'Cause heaven is a hole in the sky. The stars are cracks in the ceiling at night. But you can't be your own alibi as hard as you try. It's a tired refrain. You sing it over and over again as you try to explain who's at fault for your mistakes. But I won't be the debris in your hurricane. No, I won't be the debris in your hurricane. I won't be the debris in your hurricane.
I wrote that song kind of about a combination of people. One person I used to know back in the early aughts, and then a kid I used to be friends with when I was in high school kind of disappeared. And there's a line in that song that says, used to be such a delicate kid, a lonely fish in a sea full of squid. And I grew up in Bremerton, Washington, which is just across the water from Seattle. It's a Navy town. And one of the derogatory terms for sailors is to call them squids. So we kind of grew up, you know, seeing a pack of sailors walking around, be like, ah, there go a bunch of squids. So the idea of him being a lonely fish in a sea full of squid was kind of appealed to me. But I could understand how after the record came out, I was like, yeah, I guess that didn't really make, probably didn't make a lot of sense to most people. But that's where the line comes from. All right, I'm going to play a kind of a deep cut here that a couple of you guys requested, and then let's do some questions. So get those ready. This is a song that was a B-side from the record Plans. And it's a song I always really liked, but I don't think we ever played it live. This might be the first time it's ever been played live. Someone by the name of Arlini on Instagram requested it, as did a couple other of you. And I'm just gonna dive into it. This song is called Jealousy Rides With Me.
Jealousy rides with me.
In wake or in slumber, I can't get relief from the pictures he paints with a passion and heat. Though I try, I can't stop listening. Jealousy rides with me in wake or in slumber. I can't get relief from the pictures he paints, the passion he. Though I try, I can't stop listening. I've tried bribery, but to no effect, 'cause there's no amount of money will get him to split. As long as we're living and we're not together, I'll be chained to this beast with no chance of severance, 'cause jealousy rides with me, such a faithful companion no one could be for a journey that leads to the outskirts of time. Don't worry about me, I'll be fine. It beats being lonely, I'll be fine. All right, guys, what do you want to know here? See what's happening. Let's see. Question: are you still friends with Kelly Huckabee? I'm indeed still friends with Kelly Huckabee. He and his wife, Trisha, and their kids live in Zambia now. Zambia is in Africa. And they've lived there since 2008. They went down there on a religious mission and have kind of just decided to stay down there, what seems like kind of permanently. So they come back to the States every once in a while, and I get to see them. And they've adopted a number of kids, Zambian kids, who are all just amazing. And, you know, they're just this amazing big family. And I do miss seeing him, and I miss Trisha, and I miss their family. But we stay in touch over the socials and whatnot. What is your process for creating a song? I don't tend to keep a lot of, very rarely have any lyrics first. Usually I'll keep a little notebook or, you know, put stuff in my phone, little notes, just song starting ideas, a phrase here or there. And then I always tend to start kind of running a drum machine here in my studio or just kind of playing guitar and just kind of let my fingers find something. So it's usually melody and music first in some capacity. I'll record all that. And then once I have kind of the music, I'll allow the tone of that music to kind of set the lyrics in a particular direction. I don't think I've ever had lyrics first and then put music to that. I've never worked that way. So every song I write tends to be an expression of where I am in that particular time and place, and not necessarily, the reflection of lyrics from 5 years ago that get pulled into a new song. I do sometimes pull lyrics from songs that haven't been released to kind of start things off, but pretty much I like to kind of keep the songs fairly contemporary in kind of where they start. Do you ever listen to music when you run, or are you a purist when it comes to that? I tend to not listen to music because music has a way of marking time that can be a little bit annoying if you're on a really long run. You know, songs are usually between 3 and 5 minutes, and if you're kind of hurting, not having a great day on the trails or on the roads for that matter, it tends to kind of not work for me. When I'm out on like long trail runs by myself, sometimes I listen to podcasts. That way I can keep the volume down in case you know, there's somebody behind me, or God forbid, like an animal is near me. I can hear that, which has happened a couple times, honestly. But every once in a while on a race, like on like the last couple 100-mile races I've run, late in the race, I might need music just to kind of keep me going. But it's not something I tend to listen to when I just go out on a run around Seattle or whatever. You have a few tracks that reference religion. What role does religion play in your life now? I grew up Catholic, as I feel like I've documented many times in songs. And I identify as an agnostic now. I have the utmost respect for people of faith, and I respect the role that religion plays in people's lives. But for me, I'm just not sure. I'm okay in not knowing the answer. I think some people, for very understandable reasons, faith provides them a particular comfort. And I feel okay not knowing. And I feel that if there is a higher power, that higher power would probably be okay with me not committing either way. I know that goes against a lot of people's religious dogmas, but that's just how I feel. So I'm okay not knowing, and I'll get the answer when I die, as we all will. Let's do two more. Let's see. Do you think if Give Up had blown up before you went on to tour, there might have been more than one record? I don't know. It's hard to say. I trying to do two bands is virtually, it's not sustainable for any period of time. And in 2003, when I was touring with the Postal Service earlier in the year and then Death Cab later in the year, so that was Plans and Transatlanticism came out that year. I'm sorry. Give Up and Transatlanticism both came out that year. So it was a big year for me creatively. And I was on the road a lot between those two projects. There's no way I would have maintained my sanity if I had tried to keep them both going at a proper click. And Jimmy and I tried to start doing some music in 2004, 2005, and it just didn't really work. I think it was kind of that record was kind of a snowflake. All right, let's do one more here. Let's see. I'm gonna get a good one here. Oh, wait, I saw one I was gonna grab. Where did it go? There it is. What's the story between kids in 99? When we were living in Bellingham in 1999, there was a submerged pipeline that exploded in the Whatcom Creek area of Bellingham. There were some kids that were the pipeline was leaking, had been leaking for some time. And there was a gentleman fishing there and some kids kind of playing in the creek, as kids tend to do. And there was talk of maybe the kids were playing with fireworks. That's never been, I think the families of the children dispute that, but there was an explosion. There were multiple deaths, and it was a very kind of traumatic experience for the city. I remember Nick and I were in our house working up, playing music, and the lights all kind of flickered. It was a beautiful day, I think, and it was a beautiful day. And we're like, oh, the lights kind of flickered. And Nick had went upstairs for something, and he was like, holy shit, you gotta get up here. And there was just this plumes of black smoke about a half mile away, just pouring up into the atmosphere. And it was a really, really terrible moment for the city. It just, not outside of the loss of life, which was absolutely horrible, it also destroyed an area of a natural area that was much beloved in the city. And for me at the time, it really kind of highlighted, you know, what the dangers that we live with when we are so tied to our use of fossil fuel. So I wanted to kind of write a folk song about that. And I wanted to kind of commemorate, you know, those kids, kind of write a folk song, and so that they weren't forgotten by people other than those who knew them. All right, I'm gonna get back to some tunes here. just today, I saw a post. I made a little Instagram story about it, but somebody was, it was a Rolling Stone story about how music supervisors and labels want happy songs right now. They want positive songs, you know, to kind of keep people upbeat. And I just made a little crack about how that, you know, my phone hasn't been ringing for those kind of songs for obvious reasons. But I'm going to play my contribution to this quarantine time. I've played it a couple times, but I figure this is a good opportunity for it too. Sidewalks are empty, bars and cafes too. Streetlights only changing, cause they ain't got nothing better to do. You say it's like Christmas when nobody's around, or when our city was still a secret before those carpetbaggers came to town. The airports and train stations were full of desperate people, trying to convince the gate agents that not all emergencies are equal. No one's going anywhere soon. Inside the Safeway, it's like the Eastern Bloc. People have a way of getting crazy when they think they'll be dead in a month. But you like the silence of the wind through the trees, and I like walking beside you through these days of no guarantees. National Guard is on their way to protect us from our neighbors, and anyone who's tried to swim for it is drowned out past the breakers. The airports and train stations are full of desperate people. No one's going anywhere soon. No one's going anywhere soon. I'm going to bring in a different guitar here for this next one. My friend, my old friend Brent Cole from the Bellingham days. Been running a wonderful magazine up there in Bellingham called What's Up for 22 years, I believe. And he asked me over text, he was like, hey, do you ever use any alternate tunings? And without thinking, I said, no, I never do. Not realizing that this song I'm about to play uses a very, very alternate tuning. This is a song from the record Kintsugi. And if you want to play it at home, the tuning from low to high is C, G, C, E, G, C. So it's a pretty, very strange open tuning, but I really like it. So, this one goes out to, who does it go out to? Somebody asked for it, didn't they? This goes out to CMW 1130. Hold on 1 second, let me start this again. Right, let's do that again. You've haunted me all my life. Through endless days and countless nights. There was a storm when I was just a kid. Strip the last coat of innocence. You've haunted me all my life. You're always out of reach when I'm in pursuit. Long-winded and suddenly there's a flaw in my heart's design. For I keep trying to make you mine. You've haunted me all my life. You've haunted me all my life. You are the mistress I can't make a wife. You've haunted me all my life. So I wait, but I never seem to learn. How to capture your diminishing returns. I still see you through the eyes of a child. Not even thinking you could tame. You've haunted me all my life. You've haunted me all my life. You are the mistress I can't make a wife. You've haunted me all my life. You've haunted me all my life. You've haunted me all my life. You are the mistress I can't make a wife. You've haunted me all my life. I'm sure whatever format you guys are watching this on, you can see that there down below here is a link to an organization called Hunger Intervention here in Seattle, which is working on many fronts to kind of combat what is turning out to be a very severe issue of people, mostly low income, being able to get proper meals and groceries and the like. And they are doing a wonderful job of helping facilitate not only getting groceries and meals to elderly people, but also kids who would normally be on a lunch program if they were in school, who are now at home, putting a strain on families that are already low income and trying to feed themselves. And they are helping with that as well. So if you're enjoying the show, or if you're not enjoying the show, but hopefully you're enjoying the show, and you're able to make even a small donation, as I say every week, I would very much appreciate it. And I know that they would as well. Look out. So if you're able to do that, I would very much appreciate it. The song goes out to Janice in the chat. I said at one point, I think this is one of my least favorite songs that I've written, but apparently, a lot of you guys like it, so I'm going to give it a shot. And I mean that in the most, the least snarky way possible. All right, here we go.
Once knew a girl in the year hands of my youth lies like the summer, all beauty and true. In the morning I fled, left a note and it read, someday you will be loved. I cannot pretend that I felt any regret. Each broken heart eventually mend, as the blood runs red down the needle and thread, someday you will be loved. You'll be loved, you'll be loved like you never have known. And the memories of me will seem more like bad dreams, just a series of blurs like I never occur. Someday you will be loved. You may feel alone when you're falling asleep, and every time tears roll down your cheeks, but I know your heart belongs to someone you've yet to meet. Someday you will be loved. You'll be loved, you'll be loved like you never have known. And the memories of me will seem more like bad dreams, just a series of blurs like I never occurred. Someday you will be loved. You'll be loved, you'll be loved like you never have known. And the memories of me will seem more like bad dreams, just a series of blurs like I never occurred. Someday you will be loved. Someday you will be loved.
I feel I should mention that I when I say that when I say that that you I it's, it used to be one of my least favorite songs that I've written, but I have to say, I've played it a couple times on the show, and I'm starting to kind of fall back in love with it, actually. I think it works really well in this format. I think when I think about the version that we recorded, I feel like we tried to make it something that it wasn't. It sounds really nice in kind of like a House of the Rising Sun kind of mode like that. So thank you, Janice, for recommending it, because while I say it's my least favorite song, it doesn't always have to stay that way. All right, I'm going to play a cover tune for you now by one of my favorite bands, and actually it's Rachel's favorite band. This is a song by the band Depeche Mode, and I think it is my favorite song of theirs, even though I do not think it is their best song. It's certainly not their most well-known song, but I've always had a soft spot in my heart for the Depeche Mode songs that Martin Gore sings. Dave Gahan is, of course, the singer of Depeche Mode, but I've always loved Martin Gore's voice, and it's actually in a really good range for me. So I'm going to do this song. This song is called The Things You Said. Oops, started off good. Oh my God, let's do it. I gotta do it right though, at least.
I heard it from my friends about the things you said.
I heard it from my friends about the things you said. They know me better than that. They know me better than that. They know my weaknesses. They know my weaknesses. I heard it from my friend about the things you said. I heard it from my friends about the things you said. How could a view become so twisted? How could a view become so twisted? They know my weaknesses. They know my weaknesses. I get so carried away. You brought me down to earth. I thought we had something precious. Now I know what it's worth. I heard it from my friends about the things you said. I heard it from my friends about the things you said. I've never been so disappointed, never felt so disappointed. They know my weaknesses. They know my weaknesses. They know me better than that. They know me better than that. Stumbled around that one a bit, but you get the idea. All right, folks, I'm going to play one more tune for you. Next week's show will be at the same time. And I got my work cut out for me next week. Next week will be an all Beatles cover set. So I gotta start practicing like when I get off this broadcast. But I've got a bunch of songs in mind. I'm gonna try to stay away from a lot of the kind of standard tunes. Not standard tunes, but the ones that everybody kind of knows. You know, everybody knows Yesterday and Across the Universe, it's like that. Those are all wonderful tunes, but I kind of want to weave you guys through kind of some of my favorite Beatles tunes, which are a little somebody went, ugh, Beatles. Well, I guess he won't be watching next week. I kind of want to weave you guys through some of my favorite Beatles tunes that have a lot of meaning to me personally. So we'll do that next week. And I hope you guys have a lovely next 6 or 7 days. I hope everybody stays safe. Thanks for watching, you guys. Really appreciate it. Thank you.
love of mine. Someday you will die, but I'll be close behind. I'll follow you into the dark. No blinding lights or tunnels to gates of white. Just our hands clasped so tight, waiting for the hint of a spark. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied, illuminate the notes on their vacancy signs. If there's no one beside you when your soul embarks, then I'll follow you into the dark. In Catholic school, as vicious as Roman rule, I got my knuckles bruised by a lady in black. I held my tongue as she told me, son, fear is the heart of love. So I never went back. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied, illuminate the notes on their vacancy signs. If there's no one beside you when your soul embarks, then I'll follow you into the dark. You and me have seen everything to see, from Bangkok to Calgary, and the soles of your shoes are all worn down. The time for sleep is now, but it's nothing to cry about, 'cause we'll hold each other soon in the blackest of rooms. And if heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied, illuminate the notes on their vacancy signs. If there's no one beside you when your soul embarks, then I'll follow you into the dark. And I'll follow you into the dark.
Thank you very much, everybody. Two things before I go. Number one, our own Zach Ray over at Instagram at Grumpy Beard is about to begin the Grumpy Hour, in which he makes a signature cocktail. He teaches us all how to do it and plays a jazz record. And I believe he might have a special guest tonight. So head over there if you can't get enough Death Cab related material. And secondly, related to the show next week, which will be all Beatles covered, I highly recommend that you watch it live, because there's a very real possibility that it might be pulled down after I do it. It might not be able to live on the internet due to some copyright reasons. So tell your friends, tell your parents, and we'll see you guys next week. Thanks for hanging out. All right, bye.